In this illustration, we'll analyze the space intensity of microwave sources. Here we are given that two coherent microwave sources of frequency 1 MHz are oscillating in same phase and kept at a separation of 150 meter. And using a detector, intensity of microwave is measured at faraway position at an angle theta from the reference line, as shown in the figure. And it is saying if the maximum intensity recorded in space is I naught, we are required to find I as a function of theta. So here we can analyze if these are the two sources S1 and S2. And the separation between the sources is considered as D. Then with respect to reference line, if we consider a direction at an angle theta, in the direction the two waves which are going from S1 and S2, the path difference in the two waves will be given by this distance delta. And if this angle is theta, this is also theta. And here we can calculate in solution that for a point far away from sources, path difference in the two waves is, this can be given as delta and this must be d sine theta. So in this situation we can now calculate the phase difference between waves. And that can be given as 2 pi by lambda multiplied by delta. So that is 2 pi by lambda multiplied by d sine theta. In this situation, if we substitute the value of lambda, that can be given as c by n, and the frequency of sources we are given with 10 to the power 6 hertz. So here we can write the phase difference is equals to 2 pi by lambda, we can write as c by n multiplied by d sine theta. So this we can numerically calculate. So this 2 pi, the value of d given here is 150 meters. So this 2 pi multiplied by 150 divided by c by n, c is 3 into 10 to power 8. By n is into 10 to power 6 multiplied by sine theta. So if you numerically solve it, this is simply giving us pi sine theta. So this is the value of phase difference between these two waves from source 1 and source 2 at a far away point. So in this situation, we can calculate intensity in direction theta from a reference line is this I theta, we can write as I max cos square phi by 2. As if the two waves are having equal intensities, then intensity at the point of constructive interference for the two waves can be written as 4 times individual intensities, which is I max. So here I max is given as I naught, so this I naught cos square, phi is pi sine theta, so this will be half pi sine theta. So this is the intensity as a function of theta, which is the result of this problem.